what are the key qualities of a scientist? I think one could put that question in a different way and say, if you had 10 scientists in the room, 10 scientists, you know, like me, towards the end of their careers, and you ask them what makes a good scientist, what are the qualities you need, would they be very different from one another? And I think not. I think I've sat on enough appointments committees in enough different countries to believe that there's a kind of universal currency in science quality, which doesn't vary very much from person to person or place to place. So what are the things which are needed? Well, I mentioned Vision, in its German connotation, vision. I think that's perhaps the most important quality, and it's obviously closely allied to imagination. But it's also tempered with realism. The vision, which is somehow out of focus or in the wrong direction, is no use to anybody. There's got to be a perception of what has been done before. I seem to remember a long, long time ago, I read a book or looked at a book written, I think, by an Australian author, which said how to do science. And it started with, you know, you have to read up everything which has been done before. I don't think that at all. I think you have to pick an intellectual thread running through what's been done before and try to identify what's missing. I think that's terribly important. Do I have anything original to say on this subject of what makes a good scientist? I think not.
Is there anything original to say about anything?
Well, there are, yes. If you're too much of a Pollyanna, which perhaps I am, I agree that there's a, one would like to say something deep about good qualities.